Hello. In today's lecture, we focus on the use of mass balances. Mass balances play an important role in the design and operation of many industrial installations. In many plants, raw materials are converted into products. To save material, energy, and money, this is done in the most efficient way. Nowadays, sustainable operation is required for the sake of future generations. Balances play a crucial role here. What is it, a mass balance? We are going to answer this question via the following example. Suppose we have a reactor with a process in which methanol, CH3OH, is one of the components which enters and leaves the reactor. We measure the mass of methanol flowing in and flowing out. In this example, we take that more methanol is flowing in than out. What is the reason for this difference? We could think of methanol is produced in the process, methanol is chemically converted into other products, or there is a methanol leak. Leaking would mean that there is another outflow of methanol. We could measure that as well and calculate if the two outflows together are now the same as the inflow. In this example, we take that there is no leak and that more methanol is flowing into the reactor than is coming out. We have now two options. One, methanol stays behind in the reactor, or two, methanol is converted to something else inside the reactor. In this example, we take that methanol accumulates in the reactor by absorption on an impurity that stays in the reactor. If we generalize this example and cast our idea in a mathematical equation, the general mass balance can be written as accumulation equals inflow minus outflow plus production minus consumption. Keep in mind that the idea of the balance is very generic, and you probably have used it quite often. For instance, to keep track of the money you have in your wallet or on your bank account. The more you spend, the less money is in your wallet. Unless, of course, you balance this by putting more money into your wallet. Let's go back to our general mass balance. Usually, we combine the last two terms, production minus consumption, into a total production, as consumption is negative production, and the other way around. Note that the total production can thus be negative. It is convenient to even further shorten our notation and write accumulation equals in minus out plus production. Let's review the terms one by one. Inflow is the amount of material entering the system. Outflow is the amount of material leaving the system. Production is the amount of material that is chemically produced or converted from other compounds in the system. And finally, accumulation is the change in the amount of material in the system as a function of time. This general balance can be applied to any material entering or leaving a certain volume. It can be applied to small scales, like a cell, to a reactor vessel, or to a complete industrial plant. To illustrate how we set up and use balances, we will look at the population of a country. Thus, we need to think about in and outflow. That is, however, only possible if we clearly define the boundaries of the country. These define the boundaries of our system. In this example, we assume that each year 100,000 people enter the country. 30,000 people leave the country each year, giving the in and outflow. 170,000 babies are born and 140,000 people pass away, giving a production of 30,000 people. This balance shows that each year the population of the country growth with 100,000 people. As we mentioned before, a balance can be applied to all kinds of processes. For instance, ethanol, C2H5OH, can be oxidized into acid, CH3COOH. This happens, for example, in a bottle of wine that is left open. In this lecture, we will analyze a process with a continuous in and out flow of ethanol. At the same time, oxygen flows into and out of the vessel, while in the reactor, the ethanol is converted into acetic acid and water. The sketch shows the general picture of the in and out flows, as well as the production. We will change our notation so that it better reflects the flows. You see that the mass flow rate of ethanol is indicated by phi sub me, in and phi sub me, out. Both these flows have units kilogram ethanol per second. They indicate how many kilograms ethanol in a second enter or leave the reactor. The subscript ME denotes M for mass and E for ethanol. We use this to indicate that it's a mass flow of ethanol. The mass flow rates of oxygen are similarly written as phi sub MO, in and phi sub MO, out. And the mass flow rate of the produced acid and water by phi sub MA out and phi sub MW out. We write them as outflows as both leave the reactor. Now we can set up a mass balance of one species of the process, for example, ethanol. Again, we write down accumulation equals in minus out plus production. The production is negative, and we will denote it by minus R sub E. It is the amount of ethanol that reacts with oxygen to acid per unit of time. The in and out flows are denoted by phi sub ME, in and ME, out. We see on the left-hand side that we have written the accumulation term in a specific mathematical form, the ddt of M sub E. This denotes in a formal mathematical way that the mass of ethanol inside the reactor is changing over time. Check out one of the glass plates examples where we show how mathematically to do this. Applying this all to ethanol gives us the following mass balance. Summarizing, we can say that setting up a mass balance is a kind of bookkeeping. You can apply balances to people, but also to a certain chemical species like ethanol in a process. That is all for this lecture. Please make the exercises, always starting with a sketch of your problem. See you next time.